Welcome to another episode of GUR Codes. In this episode, I will be talking about gesture recognizers in Xamarin.Forms. It's, well, kind of a basic thing, so I think it's level 100. So it shouldn't be hard to follow along. You should have some knowledge about how Xamarin.Forms works, but that's probably why you're looking at this video right now. So let's just have a look at what gesture recognizers are. So you probably all know a simple button. As you can see here, I've just started a new project and I've commented out the normal label that is generated for you when you start a Xamarin.Forms application, and I've replaced it with a button which has a event handler in the code behind, which does nothing fancy. It just shows you an alert. So if we just run this, it will take a little while to get up here. Okay, here we go. The app is coming up and we have a button in the center, and when we tap it, it shows an alert. So nothing fancy going on, but the thing I want to show you here is that you have a button which is tappable by default, which is what you would expect because else it's not much of a button. But there are use cases where you want to see if another element is tapped, or maybe if someone has done the pan gesture on it. A lot of apps and, well, the phones support it. The gestures, you swipe left, you swipe right, you swipe up, and you do the thing with two fingers where you zoom in or zoom out. All that kind of things are gestures. So this is just a very simple tap gesture. And for a button, it just works. It just taps and it does something. But for instance, a label doesn't. If we comment out this one and put this back on and we run it again, then we will see the app coming up again and we see a label, but when we tap it, nothing happens. But what if you want to detect that this label is tapped? So you might think that there is a clicked event or something here, but there isn't. So how are we going to do this? The guys at Xamarin already accounted for this. Basically every visual element, which is at the root of all the controls here, have the ability to add gesture recognizers to it. This is a collection. You can actually add more, but let's just add a tap gesture recognizer for now, which is the simple one. It detects a tap and it has all kinds of properties that can help you, like the number of taps required. It's default one, so it just acts on one tap. But you can also make this multiple. But be warned, there is a maximum to it. I think on Android, if you do more than two taps, it won't work. I've once spent a couple of hours, okay, maybe not hours, but too much time on finding out why my Easter egg 10 times tap didn't work, and it turned out that Android only can see two taps. So be warned, if you want to use this for more than two, you have to solve it else, like just set it to number of taps required one and add a counter in the back code for that. That on a side note. There are some other stuff in here. You can work with a command. If you are going to bind properties to this, then you probably want to use commands. But you can also have the tapped event or do something with a callback and a parameter. Let's just look at the tapped right now. Handle tapped, which is probably the same signature as the clicked one. Whoops. Like this, and I'd like to say private here. And whenever we run it now, the app will come up again with the same label as we've seen before. But now, whenever we tap it, it should give us a message, and here we go. Okay, so this works, and if we want to do this for like something else, what do we have more? We can also put it in a grid if we want to. So if we put up a grid here, and well, let's just take this label and we put it in a grid, then you can just take this and put it one level up. So functionally speaking, this doesn't change anything, but let's just have the grid come up at the center as well. Functionally, this doesn't change anything. It will still show us the message like you've did before, like you've seen before on the label. But this can come in handy when you have some. See, it still works. When you have some complex layout going on in this grid, you can just say, okay, I want for the full contents of this grid, I want it to have a tap gesture recognizer. And this way you can create your custom view cell or that kind of stuff and just make it tappable and do whatever you want like this. You can basically add this to any visual element and make it work. Now I will be just showing you the tap gesture recognizer, but there is some others built into Xamarin.Forms as well. You can see it here on the documentation page. By default, you also get the pinch gesture recognizer and the pan gesture recognizer. So that's whenever you go like this. See the dots on the screen? Let me just put it in the app here. This simulates your fingers, the two dots. So this is a pan and this is a pinch gesture, and you can recognize those as well. Actually, let's just see if we can. We can get it in here. So here we could just change this with pinch. Should be enough. Oh, and then the event is not called tapped anymore, but it's called pinch updated. And it actually has another signature, so I need a new method here, which will just show another alert. And it has another signature because here in the event you can see, okay, you have some additional properties like the point of origin and the status, whether the gesture is started or running or finished. So we can say if status is, let's say started. So when we start, make the pinch gesture, it should alert us. So let's see if we can make this work. I have to, there we go. I had to hit the grid here now, so let's just do it like this. And you see, whenever I do a pinch, the message comes up. And when I do a pan, well, it actually sees that as a pinch as well right now. So There's something going on. Or I'm, well, I don't know, maybe it's the simulator not tracking my movement right. But you can see how this works. And I think there's a couple of other libraries out there which add some extra gestures right here. I think there is the MR gesture library, Xamarin. Ah, here you go. MR gestures, and these has a couple of more. Long press, pinching, panning, swiping, rotating. So there's all kinds of stuff here, and it works on basically every element. So this is worth checking out. Okay, so that's it for now. I will put this code up on my GitHub, and please follow me on my YouTube channel. I could use another couple of subscribers so I can get one of those fancy custom URLs. And of course, subscribe to any other channel that you are watching this on. So thank you for watching, and I hope you will join me for a next episode.